Right, our next speaker is Marie Mihala Lucas, who will be making some concluding remarks and tell us about what's next.
If we try to evaluate the situation, I think we see some changes and more opportunities for secularists to be heard, partly because of the atrocities which are in the newspapers every day with what happens in the Middle East. But I also see, for instance, that a lot of people who used to march nearby fundamentalists, for instance, when there was the war on Iraq at the time of Saddam Hussein, now refuse to march with an ISIS flag around. And I see this in Paris, I saw it in New York also. So this is a change which I think may, if we are lucky, may indicate that people understand that theocracy is not the solution to political problems. On the other hand, we see that there is more and more global awareness of the need for secular state and secular laws. And within this global awareness, I think there are more and more believers who stand by secularists or atheists, which I think is very encouraging for us. And for instance, we could see it with the déjeuners. These are the people in North Africa who publicly eat during Ramadan. Lots of people come to stand in solidarity, even if they fast. So that's also an encouraging sign. And there are more and more young people, at least in North Africa and the Middle East, who declare themselves atheists publicly with all the terrible consequences that they face. Now, what we have seen in this past 2 days is that there are lots of very small initiatives everywhere to stand for secularism. And we need to know more about what's going on in a very, you know, precise way. Who is doing what, where? For instance, we heard of the déjeuners, but we also heard of this campaign for secular education. However, we need to learn a lot more about local and people's initiatives. For instance, we haven't heard of COJ in Bombay, which is producing teaching material for children for secular education. And we haven't heard of Pervez scientific videos to counter the magical thinking of Muslim fundamentalists, that God punishes you by floods and by this and that. And we haven't heard of the movement to unbaptize, which is going on in Europe. And we haven't heard, of course, because we couldn't bring all these people, the movement to declare oneself officially a pagan in Central America. So we need to know more about the small people initiatives, and we need to make this knowledge available to everybody. We need to network, we need to exchange information about not only the situations, but also the strategies people are using. This is at the level of people to people, and I think that's the most important part. We also need to do research on our secular history in all our countries, and we need to multiply initiatives which could be similar to this one or different. And I have heard in passing of the possibility of a film festival for secular films, and also a similar or a conference on secularism in South Asia. So let's hope that this is not the end, but the beginning of something, of networking, and we have to organize it. On the other hand, we only heard of one example of challenging the EU or the OIC or the non-aligned and the UN, the Pope, confronting the coming of the Pope at the European Parliament. So we need more people who devote time to challenging what has been very sophisticated and successful lobbying of fundamentalists at global level and with global institutions. And finally, I think we desperately need to start something which does not exist yet, which would be a global organizing for the protection of endangered secularists and atheists. We need to create a fund to be able to exfiltrate them when it's needed. It exists for other categories of people, like the endangered scholars, but it does not exist for us. As a conclusion, I would say we need to continue walking the very fine line between challenging racism and xenophobia without ever giving, wittingly or unwittingly, directly or indirectly, support to fundamentalists. And a very good example of this is the book which has been recently released by Women Against Fundamentalism, which is outside here, which describes exactly how to walk this fine line. And we need to continue challenging imperialism without ever allying with fundamentalist forces.